Joining us now is CNN political analyst Kirsten Powers, Trump supporter and contributor to The Hill, Kayleigh McEnany. Van Jones is busy tonight. He's got a messy truth town hall getting underway right after 360. Also, former Georgia GOP Congressman Jack Kingston. Kirsten, I'm not sure where to begin on this, but that press conference today at the White House, I mean, the White House has gotten in deep on this and doesn't seem to be able to back out.
Well, I mean, they're in a bad situation because obviously they have to, Sean Spicer has to defend Donald Trump because he doesn't want to back down from this. I mean, what really struck me the most today was when he rolled out the evidence, basically, right? You know, and so, you know, Donald Trump tweeted, "I just found out," and then he went on this, you know, tweet rampage about how he was wiretapped. I think most of us, when we hear that, we think, "I just found out something. Oh, someone came in and briefed you." Like if I said to you, "Anderson, right. I just found out something," and I said, and then it turned out I just found out by reading it in the newspaper, you'd be like, "Well, that's not really just finding out. That's everybody knows that." And it turns out what it was that he just found out was he was watching Fox News, and so he found out something from Sean Hannity and he found out something from Andrew Napolitano. That's kind of embarrassing for the White House, I think. You know, I don't think that this is how we think of the president. Making a kind of accusation like this based on something like that.
And you know, Kayleigh, we've talked about this before. Having believed that, the president could then pick up the telephone, call the director of national intelligence, the FBI, and find out, was there a FISA court warrant, you know, issued? Seems like none of that was done.
Sure, and I mean, the reason Sean Spicer gave us is he says then the media would go crazy because they're interfering in the intelligence community's activities and there should be a separation. So that's his reason, whether we like it or not. But I think there are two really important things that we need to separate. Number one, Devin Nunes has said, Democrats, Republicans alike have said, Obama did not order a direct wiretapping of Trump. At this point, doesn't seem like that happened based on everything we know from both sides of the aisle. That being said, there is another separate, very serious matter that I think is what President Trump's tweet was getting at, which is Mike Flynn's conversations were transcribed in the course of surveying a foreign diplomat. DNI procedures say when you come across American citizen, stop unless you have evidence of a crime or very strong suspicion. Why didn't they stop? Why was an American's conversations transcribed in the middle of a heated election? Someone who might very well have been in Trump Tower when this was taking place. That incidental wiretapping, those questions aren't answered. And that could very well validate what President Trump was getting at.
But isn't it my understanding, and you probably know more of this than I do, in certain circumstances, the name can be unredacted if they believe a crime perhaps has been committed?
No, that's certainly true. But at the same time, they still need some sort of evidence before they transcribe and then disseminate around government Mike Flynn's conversation. It was disseminated far and wide. Why weren't the minimization procedures followed from the get-go?
Okay, Van, that is not, though, what President Trump was tweeting about at 6-something a.m. on a Saturday morning.
Listen, there are all kinds of things in our government that could be improved. Frankly, I was concerned under the Obama administration that, you know, the intelligence community might have these superpowers and that kind of stuff and new tools. There is a way to have that conversation. You could say, listen, I am the president of the United States. I'm concerned about intelligence. I want to have tweeting out some completely made up nonsense 2 weeks ago is not how you have a conversation about any of these issues. So I think we need to talk about what's really going on here. Here's what's really going on. 2 weeks ago, the president gave a speech that was well received by many, including myself, quite famously. And then the next day, rather than him getting his wonderful, you know, high of praise, people started talking about the fact that Jeff Sessions had committed an act of treason, that the top cop had committed a crime. And Donald Trump, by all reports, started going off on people, screaming and yelling. And guess what? He then tweeted out some nonsense to change the subject. Now, we're not sitting here talking about the fact that the top cop committed an act of perjury. We're talking about total nonsense. So Trump is winning again by doing nutty stuff and having us chasing the rabbit around the barn. I'm going to tell you right now, there is no way in the world that you can spin or polish what that tweet. You just can't do it. But in fact, I don't think Trump is that mad that we're not talking about Jeff Sessions.
But Congressman Kingston, does it, you know, Van is saying this is sort of Machiavellian way to turn the attention away, and we're kind of going down that rabbit hole. But you can't ignore what the President of the United States, when he's making allegations against the former President of the United States, allegations which are incredibly serious.
I don't think you can ignore it. And if you listen to what Sean said today, he said one of the things that bothered the White House is on his way out the door, President Obama apparently opened up the surveillance or the investigation to 16 other agencies who had not been involved in it, and thus spreading the information, continuing surveillance, continuing whatever investigation level there was, and improving the likelihood of leaks. And I think that is something that the White House is very concerned about. But one thing that I also want to mention, if Devin Nunes and other Republicans come out and say there was no evidence of wiretapping, in 2 weeks or three, whatever it is, when they come out and say there's no evidence of collusion, I hope that the Democrats equally embrace their statements at that time as they have today.
We're going to take a quick break. We're going to continue this conversation.